Bio-enforcement has evidently collapsed and crime has reached unprecedented proportions throughout the city. One wonders what impact the Buyamthetho program has yielded. In spite of these challenges, the city has returned almost 300 million in various grants, which funds were allocated to these critical services. As a government led by the ANC, we remain committed to dealing with and uprooting corruption and malfeasance in the city of Johannesburg. Statements have been made, ladies and gentlemen, that 34 billion rands have been lost through corruption. And despite all our efforts to gain evidence in this regard, even through the Municipal Accounts Committee, none of these have been forthcoming. The current modus operandi in the city is not one to follow transparent tender processes, but to use Regulation 32 to award contracts in most instances to companies that lack the requisite competencies. In the last 3 years, we have endured divisiveness and highly political, toxic political and administrative environment. With this administration, we plan to do things differently. It is unfortunate that we've lost 3 years of well thought plans that were either stopped as frivolous or rushed through as part of the PR exercise, alluded as such. Access to free Wi-Fi, which meant that kids in the township who have no access to IT infrastructure are able to do their homework, are able to access the information highway, has been stopped. The Josie at Work program, which is the mutual co-production that ensured services are rendered by people who stay in those communities together with the city, has been stopped. Corridors of Freedom program has been stopped. Youth Mobile Open University has not happened in the last 3 years. We'd like to continue with the infrastructure investment program of 100 billion rands that was announced previously. The city is lacking in infrastructure. Food banks that have provided social safety nets to the poorest have been stopped. Access to free basic water, 6 kiloliters of water universally, has been stopped. This will be reinstated as a matter of priority. Ladies and gentlemen, the power of local government is in the hands of the citizens. Residents, communities, and employees must work with us to ensure that the power is in the hands of the citizens of Johannesburg. We are committed to rebuilding the relationships with the community, creating an enabling environment for all the workers of Johannesburg to work, addressing soft issues that directly contribute to the social fabric of society. We will focus on service delivery. We will ensure that we reinstate the 6 kiloliters of water. We'll continue with the program of electrifying informal settlements. We'll ensure that garbage is collected 3 times a day. We'll build integrated human settlements. We'll upgrade hostels and we'll maintain the road infrastructure. We will establish, together with the city manager and the staff, a joint operation center composed of all city managers to ensure that we coordinate all operations around the city. Ladies and gentlemen, the city of Johannesburg has to be a safe city. We will do everything possible to ensure that people live, work, and play in a safe city.